Welcome back to MMA Inside the Cage. Cyrus Fees alongside Casey Ox and I for our look back at the year that was 2013. Now, so far, we've given out two awards. Luis Sapo Santos taking Fighter of the Year and Edward Remia taking Promoter of the Year. Now, it's the big one, Promotion of the Year.
For two straight years, it's been EFC Africa with the title, and they could be in line for another one this year. Let's hear it for the nominees, partner.
First up, the current champion in EFC Africa, nine big shows in 2013. And as we've said before, Cairo Howarth and the company have kept EFC Africa at the absolute highest level.
The XFC, six big shows in 2013, introduced three new champions and has found some real amazing talent in Holtzman, Sapo, Ribeiro, and Egging. And let's not forget their landmark deal with Brazil's Hedgy TV.
Cage Warriors, 13 big shows in 2013. That includes locales like the UK, Ireland, Chechnya, and the UAE, one of the busiest shows in all of MMA.
The World Series of Fighting. World Series has exploded onto the scene in 2013 and has even announced expansions in Canada, Japan. They've added big names in the calendar year, and it's going to be amazing in 2014.
Finally, Super Combat. Romanian-based Super Combat has made a case for the best K1 organization in the planet. 13 big shows in 2013, and some of the most exciting fight action we've ever been a part of. Casey, the winner is...
Cyrus, we've gone with the one, the only, XFC.
Oh, man, I feel really strongly about this, Casey. They really turned a big corner this year, and you saw what happened with Prisco. They kept their heads up, put on some great shows, found some big talent, and in 2014 with Hedgy TV, XFC MMA is going to be even bigger. We're going to close it out after the break, but right now, take a look at some of the best footage that we've shown in our main event of the week all throughout 2013.
He's trying to survive. Now, Potts throwing the barrage of punches off. Rikishi's going to want to spin to his inside.
In one-way traffic here.
And Landon Potts is full guard. Now Potts gets the mount back. He's still on Rikishi's back. Gave his back up as he rolled with him.
Potts is in complete control. Less than a minute remains in round one of this heavyweight title fight.
Rikishi landing shots on the outside now.
Oh, another big shot. Potts.
Potts very, very happy to be on his back and to
win. Huge hammer fist here.
Big hammer fist by Potts.
Trying to escape
for that single. 10 seconds to go.
Potts on his back.
Very, very happy from this position. Feels very confident.
Oh.
Fires out a head kick.
Rikishi shakes it off.
Landed by Rikishi. This time Potts goes for the takedown. He gets Bernardo
down. Gets the takedown.
Back into full side control as Potts.
He's been frantic.
Now Potts is trying to land.
Big elbows. Huge elbows.
Rob Potts is looking to finish.
Is he going to finish this one? Rikishi's cut up. It looks like it could all be over very soon.
A bloody miss. Can he hold on his own if he's not going to step in?
Elbows going to town. That's it, Ruan Potts retained.
He rocked this ring. Definitely hurts. Oh, and the Spartans come out hard here.
I think he took that personal is what happened. He is putting him up against the ropes.
And just some brutal power.
Zine Saliba's never seen competition like this, I can tell you that right now. The Spartan is really putting it on him. Those uppercuts he's throwing, if he connects one good time, Saliba will drop.
And Saliba's just not backing down at all, but just getting overpowered here when two bodies clash.
There's a reason why there's never been a loss to Saliba. Great takedown there, but he's almost put himself in position. Of course, he's not in full guard, so he's not going to get full pressure there with that guillotine. And we are going to end this first round and taking in a round number two, and I think the fans are loving this fight as well, as these guys are a little bit bigger. They're throwing hard shots. Yeah. He picks him as a Persian and picked him up and dropped him.
And Aussie Spartan too, boys.
There we go. Picked the Spartan representing Kimikai.
That's a little gash right there, man.
Zine Saliba trying to keep that perfect record.
Ooh.
Trying to hold on to the momentum.
Here we go.
Uppercuts.
The tide has turned yet again.
Yes. Saliba's got a tough chin, hasn't he?
Here we go. Kimura lock. Kimura lock attempt right here.
This could be trouble for Saliba.
Yeah, if the Spartan can get his hips out, it could be there. Giving up the position, saving his arm. But now the Spartan is on top.
This could be a big time guillotine if he can get the right.
Yeah, going after that guillotine choke.
Is he underneath that chin?
Is it there?
hip.
Wow. He is trying to peel that arm away, which we don't see enough.
Great credit to the Australian fans here in attendance at the pavilion. A lot of the times in our great land of the USA, once it goes to the ground, we hear a lot of boos.
Here we go, third and final round. Vic the Spartan Gruzik taking on Zane Saliba. Big shot, big jab there by...
Oh, nice hook to uppercut.
Those uppercuts have been devastating. He has landed some really tough uppercuts. Big shots there. Saliba is raining down the body shots. He's staying busy, staying on top, and that may be his key to victory. Ignatius Misidalis, of course, is our referee. And if it sits too stale too long, he will stand up. And then they got out
he's
of
going
it.
For that guillotine. Is it going to be enough? Wow. That's an arm in, though. It's the arm in. You really got to know what you're doing to pull that arm in guillotine. Oh, it looked like he was going after an arm bar.
Saliba, too slick. 10-second mark. Can he get it at the end? I say Saliba will coast to a victory.
Yep.
You went out by unanimous decision, red corner, Zane Saliba.
From London, England, here is Brett Basson.
Don't expect a fast start from Ling. He tends to spend a little time working out his opponents before turning the heat up.
Yeah, we've seen, John, that once it comes to the second round, he really puts his pedal to the floor. And you know, if he gets that top position, starts landing any of those elbows, it's a bad place to be under.
So Ling obviously vertically superior and will be looking to use his ranginess.
Oh! He gets clipped, and a huge right hand from Brett Bassett.
Wow.
He has been victorious here.
And like you said, Rick Alton, man, that dude is cut up,
yeah,
man.
Boy.
We'll see how that power works. Like you said, he has the Muay Thai shorts on there. You have Rick Alchin in the black and red. You have Borbatovs in the gray.
Brother, you got Bor's left leg wrapped up, man.
I'll tell you, though, you know where he fights in WFC, there are some real tough fighters over there, Casey. You mean you're talking about some real just specimens over there.
Oh, absolutely.
In the Eastern European.
The Eastern Bloc is legendary for tough athletes.
He is certainly on a big stage.
Wow, big shot by Borbatov.
Minus 190 to come back on Rainier, plus 150, and Pena explodes out of his corner.
Smart closing that gap on Rainey.
Rainey digs to the body, right hands. Knee from Rainey.
Nice
Pena looking for the takedown.
Yep, nice inside trip, but Rainey's balance, his athleticism can take over real quick.
Pena throws the legs up. Looping left hand from the sniper, and he gets two to the jaw of Pena. Pena looking for a way back to his feet. Inadvertently gives up his back, however.
Hey!
Rainey, back to his feet, single leg here from Reggie Pena. Pena looking for a takedown to no avail. Nice knee to the midsection from Ricky Rainey.
He's just wanting a better starting point than what he's got. Rainey just keeps controlling him, lifting that underhook. Now he's got that tie clinch.
Beautiful knee to the liver from Rainey. Now Pena gets free. Back to center cage. Some swelling under the left eye of the southpaw, Reggie Pena. Rainey's going to throw his right hand down the tube, and he does just that. Hit the lead foot on the outside of Reggie's lead foot. Jump to it. Rainey shoots in again, single leg, can't get the takedown on that occasion.
Pena trying that inside trip again. He's got to circle him so that leg steps forward so he can hook it.
Oh, Pena gets caught! Pena's on rubber legs! Here are the uppercuts from Rainey! Oh, the big knee! Pena in a whole lot of trouble, locks up a leg.
Pena got to get a takedown here, man. He's in trouble.
Ricky Rainey teeing off on Pena like a golf course. Another uppercut. A big gobsmacky right hand. Oh, the big kibosh. Meet me somewhere.
It is time for your main event of the evening. First, in the blue corner, fighting out of Cameroon, please welcome Daniel Lanti. And in the red corner, fighting out of Romania, Catalin Marasanu.
not push. I said stop.
Well, this is going to be a dust up right from the get-go. Lenti has a lot of skills here. I love that spinning kick. Brings up the leg, turns, brings round the heel. Needs to protect the chin though, because Morisanu doesn't take prisoners, doesn't stand for nonsense. Morisanu could have his hands full here. Spinning back fist. Oh, all kinds of problems. Daniel Lenti. Oh, Catalin Morisanu lands the shot. Lenti hasn't protected himself. Surely he must have seen the videos. You can't maintain the standard. There's a slip. Lenti says it was a slip. And there's the damage to the eye of Morisanu. So he takes this round, but he won't be happy with that. He'll need to finish decisively. Not in the best shape, Morisanu. But the southpaw can still deliver a right hand. There's the knockdown. That's all he had to do. Well, that's the pain train. The Carpathian death. Oh, it was sweet and dandy.
Well, we certainly had an amazing year in 2013. I consider it, Casey, the best in my career. I'm living out my dreams. I'm so grateful to be a part of this show, this TV network on Fight Now, and the great international shows like XFC and Super Combat. Not to mention, my wife and I brought my first daughter, Kennedy, into the world, which has truly changed my life. For me, it's going to be really hard to top 2013.
Well, from coast to ocean, to country, brother, 2013 has been the tops, but it's just the beginning. Of course, we saw my wife, Jennifer Oh, taking WMMA to another level. I'm so excited about that and everything else that 2014 is going to bring.
Oh man, it's going to be awesome. We're going to be back in 2014 and we hope everyone enjoys their holidays. Find us on Facebook, follow us at MMAITC, and subscribe to our official YouTube for exclusive content. I'm Cyrus Beast.
I'm Casey Oxendine.
We'll see you next year inside the cage.